something, y'all, man. The Spirit. He says, to they that have an ear, hear what it is that the Holy Spirit is saying. And I gotta share something with you. Holy Spirit didn't tell me to say this, but it is something that is still true that the Holy Spirit can confirm. There are a whole lot of people prophesying and speaking things into the atmosphere of the earth under the name of Jesus that Jesus did not say. He said in Matthew 24, many shall come in my name and they shall receive many. How is it that you can declare what the Lord is saying, but you don't spend time with Him? The Lord is getting ready to expose who is listening to Him and who's not. How can you declare something and say, because what the Lord has to say is beyond you and your personal ministry and establishments. I'm speaking because I believe that we're on live, so I'm speaking to the body of Christ. What the Lord has to say is just beyond you. The Lord, He's speaking a kingdom word. And what we're doing is we're speaking words that does not stretch beyond the last pew. The Lord is saying, listen to what I am saying for the earth. And it is because the prophets in the Bible understood what God was saying prophetically, because they understood the prophecies of the Old Testament that Peter, under the auspices of the Holy Spirit, said, this is that which the prophets have spoken about. As I am being recorded live, I want every man, every woman, those that say they hear the Lord, to understand something. You cannot mandate anything but yet have no biblical knowledge of what is happening according to the prophecies that are written in the Scripture. He's coming. That's the word of the Lord. No prosperity. No. No get rich scheme. No touchy feeling. Not a prophetic word to entice the flesh, that the Bible says in the last day that you would not be able to endure sound doctrine. But the Lord is declaring a word that will position His people to be ready. When I return, blessed is he who, when I come, I find him looking for me. Oh, that's the word of the Lord. The spirit of Elijah, as John to rise up. It's time for the Elijahs to rise up. But in order to be an Elijah, you gotta isolate, you gotta separate yourself from the social status of what is deemed to look good. No. Elijah, he wasn't in the synagogue, he was in the wilderness. You get it? He wasn't among the bishops and the Pharisees, and he wasn't among the prophets and the apostles. He wasn't among the man that when you decree and you speak a word, it will not be a word that has been influenced by false prophets and teachers. He's coming. He's coming. He's coming. Rise up. Yeah. Those of you who are in here, rise up. Let your light shine. Rise up. Rise up. What do you mean, rise up? Walk in your calling. Walk in your purpose. Pursue the kingdom and his righteousness. And forget about everything else, because it all shall be added unto thee. Rise up. Rise up in the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Rise up in your purpose and in your assignment. Stop trying to fit in. Stop trying to be like everybody else and rise up. Pursue the Mababasia. Press toward the mark. Press toward the assignment, the agenda. Now before we transition to what